session three, were we? Session three, coming up. Can we have everyone coming in from the RWC Cafe? And while everybody's coming in, we've just got Anka sitting up on stage. We want to welcome Anka. Come on, give them a wonderful welcome this morning. Such a blessing to have them in the house. Such a blessing to have them with us. You know, it's a long way away, and it's just awesome when people are so hungry for God that before you even open the registrations, they're asking, when is registration going to open? That is what I love. I love that. Amen? Because that shows me a hunger in the heart. People want to come wherever they know they're going to get filled from the river of life. Amen? And so I want to just ask you right now just to stand with me. We're just going to pray. And we're going to have Anka are going to play for us, and then we're going to lead into that straight into Pastor Louis' session. Did I leave anything out? Okay. And so I'm not going to welcome Pastor Louis later. I'm going to welcome him now and just say we're so blessed for session three, Pastor Louis from Beth Aron. Come on, give him a warm amen. And he's going to be sharing with us and ministering to us, and we can't wait for that. It's going to be awesome. So just allow yourself to be open to receive from the Word in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. It's over to you. Thank you, Dianka.
Amen. 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 Lord, we just want to come to you this morning and surrender. Surrender everything. All of our rules, all of our... everything, Lord, with every cell in our body, with our DNA, with spirit, soul, everything is due to you. God, and we just want to bring you praises. We want to honor you, Lord, for the King that you are in our lives. Lord, you are sovereign over us. In every area of our lives, you are sovereign. And we honor you, we honor you. As our King, please, God, accept our offerings. We break in front of you. We just want to bring you glory. Glory, glory, glory.
No, it's just so incredible. As you were praying, can I ask, who's got a shofar? Justin, could you come with a shofar? And also, if you could, Pastor Ross, just come up here quickly. I feel like we need, I tell you what I'm doing. I feel like we need to start the session with a shofar. I'll tell you why. Because there was a sound prophetically when the Lord gave me the word that we were releasing a new sound in RWC last year. A new sound was birthed in you as a band because of the new spirit that is in you. And that is the activation of Holy Spirit. Then there was a prophetic act that followed that, where a worshiping church, a church... Bloemfontein, Adonai, actually, is the name. Adonai, and they are worshippers. You gave a shofar. Am I right? Into there. So come up. Let's start this session off. Come up over here. Both of you come up. You've got three. That's even better. Four. Okay. Come and stand over here. We got this on camera. Where's Grant? Can we take some photographs, please? Oh, he's there already. He's on it. He's on it. You got it? All right. Let's stand. Okay, now come stand on the step. Now, I'm going to count to three. And I don't know if you're able to do... you got your guitar. Are you able to do like a... Yes. So on three, when I count to three... I'm going to ask you to do that on your guitar, just that, until we stop. And these shofars are going to blow until I say stop, so just if they go red in the face, you know what's going on. But while that's happening, I want you to release the sound that is in you and shout out to the Lord said, we must rejoice and sing praises. Make a loud noise and rejoice and sing praises. So what I want you to do is release that sound that is within you to set off the set. So we're going to count to three, and as they blow the shofars, I want you to release your shout. Amen? With the sound of the shofars that goes out into the spirit realm. One, two, three. Oh!
I will give him glory.
Glory.
I will give him praises.
Praises.
I will shine his light deep into the night. I will give him glory. I will give him glory.
Glory.
I will give him praises.
Praises.
Every song I sing, I just want to bring glory to my
God, he reigns.
Lord. And we love you. We love you. We just want to come to your throne, God. God, thank you for being God. In everything. God. 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 Lord, we honor you. We bow down before you. Lord, we thank you for your blood. Making us free. For meeting us. Lord, when we reach out to you and we just break before you.
That's it. Wow.
You meet us in that moment.
Yes.
You and Brother Me. You unravel us. Unravel me. Lord, we ask that you become more and more and more and more and more in us. Form us, Lord. Unform us. If you have to, transform us. Lord, just we surrender to your hands, to the potter's hand. Lord, do what you want to do. Do what you want to do. In Jesus' name.
Surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child.
Come on, there's an anointing on this. Just keep it up.
I am surrounded by the arms of the Father. I am surrounded by songs of deliverance. From the bottom.
Just lift your hands right now. We just have Philip joining from Beth Aron. You know, there's been a very strong anointing right now on this. And I believe it's because we set the order the way Holy Spirit wants us to. And that's what we did. When we came in here from tea, there was something about releasing the sound. And it activated something in the spirit realm. So let's just keep this flow. I don't know that there was one person here that was untouched this morning by this worship from Dianka. Because the Lord, see, the first thing I saw was your heart of worship to the Lord. And that activated and stirred my heart. Do you know what I'm saying? Because it was authentic. And that's what people want. Don't be like someone else. Be authentically who you created to be. Worship authentically with what God has put inside of you. You can carry apostolic DNA, you can carry DNA, but you carry your own fingerprint. So I want to just keep in the flow of this, and let's just continue to worship with the awareness of Holy Spirit and the presence of God. Very strong.
Is to our God, every word of worship in one accord. Every praise is to our God. Every praise is to our God, every word of worship. Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Church, we are in the year of Jubilee. We are in the year where we will receive back what the enemy has stolen from us. Church, let me tell you, don't sit down. We are hardly beginning. We are in the year of Jubilee. We are in the year where we are getting back what is due to us. We are in the year where the title deed for our ground is handed back to us in Christ Jesus. Amen. And that means as we stand here this morning, to be in Jubilee means whatever has been stolen from us will be returned to us. Amen. Church, this morning, if your joy has been stolen from you, it is time to take it back. This morning, church, if your health has been stolen away from you, it is time to take it back. This morning, church, if your fire has been stolen away from you, take it back. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Can I tell you that there's a second part to this Jubilee? Oh, I can't wait to tell you. The slaves will be freed. The slaves will be set free to return to their families in the time of Jubilee. The enemy might have enslaved you in certain things in your life. The enemy might have put balls and chains around your leg to make you tired whenever we need to go and make disciples and spread the gospel. We might be full of bondage. We might be oppressed by religiosity. This morning, let me tell you, we are in Jubilee. And the slaves will be set free. Those that has been enslaved by religiosity, those that has been enslaved by the lies of the enemy himself, will be set free. Therefore, this morning, God my Savior, God my healer, God my deliverer from whatever is holding me back. This morning, church, let me tell you, the prophet said last night that there would be a demonstration. I made so many notes last night for today. There will be a demonstration. Now, let me tell you, we are talking about being in bondage. We talk about being in slavery, being in Pastor Liesl, you spoke it so well this morning. Don't sit here this morning with a religious mindset. Oh, no. This is the part where the queen in me comes out, right? You know what? These hips are made for shaking, amen? And it's time to shake, right? A part of us, a demonstration of letting go of these chains that the enemy has hooked onto us is to start shaking. Is to start shaking and start moving and start demonstrating the fire, the freedom that there is in God Jesus, amen? So if you are standing here today and you are not in front, if you are not in front dancing, then you better get a flag and start waving. But you better start demonstrating God in your life. We need to start demonstrating the freedom that we have in Christ Jesus. Every praise is to our God. Let's go for this. Let's praise Him for every praise is to our God in this season of Jubilee. Amen.
Every
hallelujah.
Every praise is to our God. Every word of worship in one accord. Every praise.
our God.
March into your jubilee.
You know what? Pastor Jaden shared a powerful word the other day, and that is how the church has lost its rhythm. The church has got into such a mindset and has been so poisoned by the enemy that we have lost our rhythm. And in the year of Jubilee, it is time that we get back our rhythm. It is time to start shaking for the kingdom. It is time to start moving in our victory this morning. Start hitting those drums, and as those drums are going, I want you to find your rhythm in Christ. Quiet. Yes. Take your rhythm. Take your rhythm. Receive your rhythm in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes. 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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah, freedom, 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 hallelujah, yes, 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 yes. Savior. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is your Savior. He is your healer. He is your healing right now. He is the restorer of everything right now, this very minute. Let me tell you, it's not something that's happening tomorrow or Sunday or whenever. It is now. It is now. He is the healer right now. God, my Savior. God, my healer. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Wow, Lord, we just praise your name. We just honor you, Lord. And before your majesty, we bow down. We bow down, Lord God, for you are the great I am. Lord God, and with you, we hold on with everything that is within us. For nothing compares to you. Nothing can come. No angel, no demon can pull us away from your love. Wow, we are so honored. We are so privileged. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let me tell you, when I was praying in the Spirit and preparing for today, Holy Spirit led me on a strange path, amen? And I wasn't sure what he was about to do. But I do believe what the Spirit wants to do is busy unfolding right in front of us right now. you want to sit down, you sit down. If you want to lay down, you lie down. If you want to sit here in front, you sit here in front. We're not done yet, but I have to share a word with you. But whatever you do, don't lose focus. Whatever you do, don't run away. If your legs get tired, sit down. But let me tell you, hallelujah, hallelujah. Okay, Apostle says sit down. Sit down. Hallelujah, hallelujah. It's just me. The title of what I want to share with you today is Breaking Free into Jubilee. Breaking free into Jubilee because the enemy has been put the church, he has put the people of God in bondage for so long. That the bondage, the state of bondage has become the norm in our life. Amen. The state of bondage has become who we are in Christ. Oh, I'm a bondage, hallelujah. I'm a hallelujah with a ball and chain walking around me. And it became part of the church's identity. This morning, I want to share with you that it is time to break free right into Jubilee. Break free and move into where God wants us to be. Like I said, if we have been in bondage for so long, it becomes part of who we are. Oh, brother, how are you doing today? Oh, pastor, you know. Okay, so how's things going with work? Oh, you know. The teeth gets long. It becomes part of who we are. It becomes part of our words that we speak. And remember, our words become our destiny. So it is time for us, it's time for the church to come out and break free from a mentality from I am so aramaskepsal, I am so asistoch shame. For does the word of the Lord do not say that we are more than conquerors? Do the word of the Lord do not say, for greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world? So if that is true, why is it that we are allowing, why do we say, ach yeah, please come and put, I've got a spare space on my leg, come and put your shackle. Come and tell me how I'm not worthy. Come and tell me how I do not deserve what is coming my way. Let me tell you, we are people of our most high King, and therefore we deserve the best. We deserve the best. We do not deserve to be second best, because the word of the Lord says we are the head and not the tail. Amen. So it is time for us to break out of that mentality of saying, I am not good enough. I am not strong enough. I am not wise enough. And take back our Jubilee. But then there's a different part. And let me tell you, this enemy is getting right to the end of my tether. Because he has been lying and stealing and deceiving the people of God for too long. Because we get into a state, right? We spoke about getting into a state where we say, okay, this is now me and I'm settling with it. We made peace with not being good enough. That stops you right here now, right? Amen. But then there's another part. And that is where the people of God are being tricked and lied to by the enemy himself. He comes with subtle ways and say, oh, but you are so not worthy. You are so not you. How dare you speak up? How dare you start speaking the truth? The Bible says the truth will set you free, right? So how dare you speak the truth? Because remember, there's going to be rejection. Yeah, so the Bible says the truth will set me free. So the enemy comes with small little lies into your life and my life. Let me give you a perfect example. If we want to poison a dog, we don't give him a spoonful of poison. So here's your poison, drink it. We do not, because the dog will refuse to drink it. But when we put the big, thick, juicy piece of steak and we inject poison into it, that dog is going to devour that piece of steak. He's going to eat it, and he's going to walk away satisfied with a good meal he just had, only to realize later that his life has been stolen away from him. And that is what the enemy is doing to you and me today. That is exactly what the enemy is doing to pull us away out of our Jubilee. He's coming with small, subtle lies, all beautiful lies, to come and pull us away from our victory that we have in Christ Jesus. The truth will set you free. the book of Proverbs come and it teaches us. Dry bones. Oh no. Let me get my scripture. I can't paraphrase here. Hallelujah. The book of Proverbs comes and he says, a crushed spirit will dry out bones. Let me tell you, the enemy will do anything to dry up and to crush our spirits. He will do anything in his power to keep us away from this jubilee so that our bones can get crushed. Let me tell you, it is God's will to be victorious. It is God's will to stand bright and tall. It is God's will to stand and with power, authority, and anointing in him. Can I turn your attention to Isaiah 55, verse 1 to 13. Come everyone who thirst, come to the waters. Yeah. Amen. Come everyone who thirst, comes to the water. Who's thirsty in this place this morning? Come to the waters, my child. Come to the waters. Come and jump in. And he who has no money, come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money on that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen diligently to me and eat what is good, and delight yourself in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Hear that your soul may live, and I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. Behold, I made him a witness to the people, a leader and commander for the people. Behold, you shall call a nation that you do not know, and a nation that you did not know shall run to you, because the Lord your God, and of the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Why waste your hard-working money on things that do not satisfy you? When the enemy is coming with that big, thick piece of steak, in our life right now, and I'm talking now in the natural for a minute here. When the enemy comes and he says, but you know what? The world with the pleasures out there, the world which it has to offer, has all these things. The word of God comes and says, why waste your money on good things? Because prosperity is part of being in Jubilee. Amen. So why waste your money on things that is of this world? Buying bread of deceit instead of bread of life. Yeah. Why buy bread? Why spend my time? Why spend my time rather with things busy with the world than with things of God? Why spend my time with things that will please the world and make me look good in the world instead of being in the presence of God? Yeah. For the world has nothing to offer that will move me into Jubilee. But with God, in the presence of God, I can move straight into Jubilee in an instant. For why buy bread of deceit instead of bread of life? Yes. Hallelujah. The results will be that you shall call a nation that you do not know. You shall stand and you shall walk in the malls. You shall stand and you shall speak in life in your working environment. And the glory of God will follow you wherever you go. For wherever you set your foot, you will have the title deed. For you will have ownership wherever you move to claim the ground for the kingdom. For being in Jubilee means that what's rightfully mine has been given back to me. So wherever I put my foot, whether it's in work, with friends, with family, it doesn't matter. It belongs to the kingdom of God. And as being a kingdom child, it belongs to me. So you make fun all you want, but I will claim it for Christ. The other day I got in touch with someone and they came and they spoke to me and says, oh, pastor, I need this and this, but you have to know I'm not a Jesus freak. I said, praise God, I am. Thank you, Lord, that I can be called a Jesus freak. Because that means Jesus is the core of my being. And you can joke all you want. Not you, they, out. You can joke all you want. For greater is he that is in me. Hallelujah. Greater is he that is in me. For he that is in me will propel me right into Jubilee. He will propel me into victory, into ownership for what he has destined for me. All because God's glory will glorify us. Rain falling on a desert seems so insignificant. Have you ever watched a raindrop fall? I watch a lot of Animal Planet, just so that you know. And often you see the pictures where the rain is falling onto the desert, and that drop, the minute it falls on that dry, hot sand, it looks so useless. But what's happening inside is completely a different story. Because the minute that drop falls, something new starts to happen. There's something new that is being stirred in within. And this morning as we jump into the river, this morning as we get into the river, that rain is falling down onto desert sand. And something happens from within. Something is happening from within. And a new life will spring up. A new life, victorious and great in Christ Jesus. Now you tell me, how can people still be standing still? You tell me. Oh, am I sweating that much? Realize, sorry. Sure. Hallelujah. Luke 4, verse 18 to 19. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me for this reason. He shall anoint me to preach the gospel to the poor. Oh. Did the prophet not say last night that every one of us with your, what did you call it? The holy what? The bum? Blessed assurance. Thank you. Your blessed assurance in this place this morning. Did the prophet last night not say that you have been called to preach the gospel? Yes. So if your blessed assurance is on these seats this morning, haha, guess what? You have a job description. Go out and spread it to the poor. Yes. Where was I? Oh, I was reading, right? He has sent me to heal those who are brokenhearted, proclaim pardon to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to send forth a deliverance to those who have been crushed, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord's favor. So what is the scripture telling us? We are in the year of Jubilee. We are in the year where the lost needs to get saved. Where the lies that the enemy has spread needs to become to the truth. The truth needs to be spoken. The truth needs to come out. Guys, are you hearing what I'm saying this morning? Are you getting this? For too long have we sat and turned a blind eye. For too long did the church say, ach yeah, but it's okay. The pastor will fix it. Today, Jesus, being alive and being part of our lives, wants to come and He wants to set you free. Christ Jesus Himself wants to come through His Spirit and He wants to break you free from wherever you are. He wants to come and break you free from the lies of the enemy. For when you have had your piece of steak, only to realize, but you know what, it was lies. And I'm about to die. I am about to get into bondage. Christ Jesus wants to come and He wants to break you free. Is your heart broken in this place this morning? Is your heart broken in this place this morning? Maybe by a family, maybe by a friend, or maybe by a loved one. Let me tell you, in the Spirit, God wants to come and He wants to heal your broken heart. He wants to mend that heart that is shattered into pieces. Are you being captive by addictions? By addictions, we often think about substance. What about pornography? What about other things that is claiming a bigger priority than God in our life that is an addiction? This morning, God wants to come and He wants to break you free. He wants to release you from the chains of addiction. He wants to break you free from that addiction of being the popular one. He wants to break you free from the addiction for always having to be accepted by everyone. For long I have been in that addiction. God wants to come and He wants to break the addiction of your life. He wants to come and set you free. Lies that has blinded us by the enemy. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Lies that has blinded us from the enemy. You know what? It's not that bad. You know that phrase? It's not that bad. Today, God wants to come and He wants to set you free. God wants to come and He wants to restore your sight. He wants to say, for the truth will come and make you free. The truth will come and set your feet dancing. The truth will come and make you run for the kingdom of God. For you will have life and life in overflow. And then the crushed spirit that dries our bones. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. If a church, if a fellow follower of Christ has ever crushed your spirit, if anything in the world out there ever crushed your spirit, let me tell you, it is not the will of God. For God wants to exalt you in this place this morning. God wants to come and He wants to pick you up. And that crushed spirit, like Ezekiel, He wants to prophesy over those dry bones so that there can be life, so that there can be great army for God, so that we can march forward. There was this drum roll. Did you hear this drum roll this morning? Such an army thing going. Yeah. I love that. Oh, such a mighty army for God. So if your spirit is crushed this morning, if the enemy has lied to you, if the enemy came and he crushed you inside with all sorts of nonsense, let me tell you, I am telling you the truth this morning, that there is healing, that there is freedom, and that there is peace in the presence of God this morning. Just receive it as He is doing it in this place. It is the desire of Jesus to set us free. It is the desire of Jesus to set us free. But because we have been programmed in a certain way, because religiosity, because the world out there has programmed us in a certain way, we tend to hold on. Oh, but it's comfortable where I am right now. Can I hold on? It is comfortable with what I know. Let me tell you, God has a perfect sense of humor. God has a sense of humor. God wants you this morning to let go. To let go of the things that is keeping you away from your victory. God wants you to let go of the things that is causing you to slow down. So this morning, as you hear these words, do some investigation in your heart. And what is it that is slowing you down for the kingdom? What is slowing you down for the year of Jubilee? It is time that we stop holding back. It is time that we take back what is rightfully ours. Amen. For God gave it to me. If you are driving, I love BMW. So if you're driving a BMW and I'm taking your car, I'm still praying for mine. Yes. If I take your BMW car keys, you're going to make sure I give it back, right? As much as I would love to keep it, you're going to insist on getting it back, right? Church, this morning, God is giving us the freedom. God is giving us the healing. God is giving us the restoration. But the enemy has taken it. And this morning, we stand up and we say, it is mine. This morning, we say, it is mine. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 And as we're in this, we run to the cross. We run to the cross, and let me tell you, the enemy will do anything to keep us away from the cross, because at the cross is where lies our Jubilee. So this morning, if your past is leeching onto you, get to the cross. If your mistakes of the past, if your shortcomings is leeching onto you, get to the cross. This morning, if whatever the lies of the enemy is telling you, get to the cross. If you are tired, if you are run down, get to the cross. Get to the cross. I want us to move into a worship session here. And I do believe in my heart that this morning chains are being broken. I do believe, Apostle, with my whole heart. Chains, these ball and chains are being shattered off legs today. Yokes that is upon people. The people of God. The mighty warriors of a heavenly kingdom. will be shattered into pieces right here in this place today. As we go, we're just going to say, God, come and do. Come and do what needs to be done in this place this morning. You have a choice. God is a gentleman. He will never force himself on you. For he stands at the door and he knocks. And he knocks and he says, if you are willing to open up your heart, I am willing to break down those chains. Those lies. Those things that is holding you back. He wants to break it right now. He wants to break it right now. Because as we go into worship, like the pastor has preached, it is holding us back. It is keeping us away from true victory. And I believe this is only the beginning for the weekend, but this needs to happen. This needs to happen right now. And as we're going to go into this worship song, if there are chains in your life, if there are things that the enemy has been lying to you, ask for Apostle to pray with me, and whoever you feel fit, Apostle, that's fine. But you run to the front. For too long have the enemy stolen from you. For too long did the enemy hook chains on the people of God. Take back your victory right now. Take back your victory right now. Let's just worship. Let's just get into that worship.
So just stand for a moment, friends.
Hallelujah.
There was a very strong anointing moving, and yes. What happens is it's not that the anointing and the flow goes, it's that there's different anointings that come upon us, and now there's another anointing. And so that's because Pastor Louis brings with him a different anointing.
Yes, that is.
And so he is the heart of a pastor. And so he looks at the hearts of people.
Yes.
And he sees the hurt, the brokenness, the struggles.
Yes. Yeah.
And says, you can be free. A prophet will stand and declare you are free already.
Yeah.
But the pastor will see the heart of the brokenness and say, let's peel the onion back further.
Yes.
And then the apostle will look at the overall and begin to draw this whole picture of how it flows and where it goes. Amen? And so I want you to lift your hands right now in the presence as we led into worship. And as you feel led, just come up here and Pastor Louis will lay hands on you and just speak a release over you this morning, I think. Speak a release and break every single chain. So many chains have been broken in our lives. But if any of you have seen or watched some of the series we've done, that is exactly what it's about. We are like onions. We can be 30 years old or 40 years old or 20 years old, but we've got those 20 years where we haven't lived in the depth of the presence, and things from our childhood, things from our adulthood hurts.
Yeah.
Even though the spirit is renewed, the soul needs a few layers to be peeled off over time as we're ready. And so it's not that we haven't received our healing. We receive it by faith.
Yes.
But sometimes in the area of the soul, not the spirit, we still need things to be released.
Yes.
That's just a fact. Amen?
Yes.
And so I share this with you now because this is an apostolic impartation I give you. Understand this. Your spirit is free the moment you're born again. You are a new creation.
Yes.
Your mind still needs to be renewed though.
Yes.
And so I take this and I say right now, renew your minds.
Yes.
Renew your minds. Your mind is the area of the soul. It's your thought life. Your brain is the organ. Your thought life comes from the area of the soul. Amen?
Amen.
And sometimes there are things, and it's not a crime to be broken.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean you're not a good Christian.
Yes.
Doesn't mean you're not a mature Christian.
Yeah.
Doesn't mean you're not a prophet. Doesn't mean you're not an apostle. Doesn't mean you're not a fivefold. Doesn't mean you don't have victory. You can have brokenness and still have victory.
Yeah.
You just got to know you got the victory.
Yes.
And that's how you get healing.
That's true.
Amen?
Yes.
Hallelujah. So it's not to live in the past, but it's to say, let me be done with it in a healthy way so that I can move on from it in a healthy way so that it doesn't hinder me in whatever I'm going to do.
Yeah.
See, this is the problem. We think letting go of the past is just one sweet act of faith and okay, boom, it's done. thank you, Jesus. And then I'm all in an atmosphere of faith here. Yeah. You know, like I'm walking around here and I'm on cloud nine, but then I go out there and I face my problems and I start coping with old coping mechanisms because I haven't really got free in my mind. Yeah. And the renewing of the mind can only happen if we use the right weapons. And the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 10:4, you know, this is one of our mandate teachings, is that we have the power to demolish strongholds with the weapons of the Spirit.
That is true. Yes.
And so the first thing our minds have to get around is that. So this morning, I don't know if I'm right or wrong, Pastor Louis, but what Pastor Louis is saying is let's break the chains.
Yes.
Of those areas of the mind, of the areas of the soul, of the areas, your spirit's fine. You're born again, you're believers.
Yeah.
And if you're not, we'll give you an opportunity before the conference is over.
Yeah.
Or even after this service, go to Pastor Louis. He'll help you, lead you to the Lord. But I want to say to you right now, let God in.
Yes.
To the area of your soul.
Amen.
It's a vulnerable place. We don't want to go there. And that's why we so often deal with things the wrong way. Shut the doors, close it off, lock it up, throw away the key, padlock it 5 padlocks later.
Yeah.
And we can't understand why we're battling to maintain in our relationships and battling to, we're like, but I'm a Christian, I'm born again, my spirit's free. It's because the area of the soul has to get free, friends. God's redeemed you, the blood, the price is paid, your future. But the 20 years of all of this stuff that you've had to deal with, it's been dealt with in an unhealthy way. Most of our life still is to be dealt with.
Yeah.
And that's what God wants to do. That's the process of transformation. You see, if we didn't have to transform and it all happened in one sweet bang go, we'd all have hair standing on end like this. Because we'd be shocked beyond comprehension because the power of God would kill us. Amen. It would be too much for us if God just transformed us like instantly. It's like, whoa. Amen. So transformation, born again, instant. Spirit renewed, instant.
Yes.
I'm a new creation, instant. I'm a child of God. Amen. I'm good. I'm not, you know, I'm all that God said I am. But I recognize that there are things in the area of the soul that must be changed. And we deal with it extensively in our teachings. And I want to encourage you, friends, if you're part of this network, you need to watch my teachings. If you want to experience what God has for you, you need to watch the teachings. You need to get into your spirit. You need to be teachable and have those things in your spirit so that you can move into the fullness of what God has. Because there are things that we need to deal with that we've not dealt with. We've thought we've dealt with them so often, and they come back to bite us. And they affect everything because it's just different coping mechanisms. Amen?
Yeah.
And so I want to encourage you this morning. If you've been afraid to be vulnerable, you need to understand this. You cannot love if you've shut off the areas of emotions where you've numbed your emotions because you've been hurt and think you can still love.
Yeah.
Do you know that it's an absolute scientific fact? This is not even theology. A scientific fact that if you numb your emotions, you cannot separately say, I can love. You may think you're loving, but the actual understanding is that when you numb your emotions, everything is numbed. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that's how we isolate, shut out people, all those kind of things, have dysfunctional relationships, mess it up, get messed up, find bad soul ties. Can I tell you something? I know that I'm preaching. I'm so sorry, but this is the spirit. I'm not even going to apologize.
No.
Do you know that I talk about bad soul ties, right? It's the area of the soul, the area of the flesh. We don't realize. Do you know that even in churches and ministry ties, there can be bad soul ties? I'll tell you what they are. When you start feeding into one another because you like what you hear. That's what Timothy said when he said they want to hear what their itching ears want to hear. Because it makes them feel good about themselves because that's where they're going.
Yeah.
Be careful you don't fall off the cliff with whoever you're associated with.
Yes.
So you've got to make sure and be careful that it's not edifying the soul rather than the spirit.
Yeah.
So when your soul is edified, your flesh is edified.
Yeah.
When the spirit is edified, God is edified. Do you understand?
Yes.
So I want us to be in a position where we, listen, we're constantly letting go, but that doesn't mean we're constantly in bondage. Because you constantly come to an every new level, there's a new level of surrender. I teach this. So don't be freaked out because you think, well, every time I've just surrendered that, Lord, there can't be more. Well, if there's more, so what? Just let it go as it comes. Let it go. When you feel it, let it go. It's the holding on to the stuff that makes us so sick in our bodies, that makes us sick in our minds. Because, you know, we want to be these perfect Christians. People can't know about that. People can't know about this. I'm strong, you know. I'm a Christian. I'm a leader. I'm a pastor. No. It's when you can show your vulnerability. It's when you can stand up on a pulpit or when you can talk to a friend and tell them about your worst scenario and how God brought you through it. And the lessons you've learned from it, that is your strongest testimony. Yes. When a person can't talk about their brokenness, we're not over it. Yeah. So I want you to allow God this morning. Pastor Louis brought a very important message. This amazing time, we are in a season of Jubilee. It's a real season, people. Yeah. It's a real season, and we need to move with the seasons and the times of God. And I want to tell you right now that this Jubilee is so important because it breaks every chain over our lives. And even if they're not all falling off at once, they're broken. You might have a few rattles going along, but as you're ready, you're going to release them, okay? But the chains are broken. Amen? So come up right now. Before we break for lunch, just come up. Thank you. Pastor Louis.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Philip is going to sing us a song, and by starting off this session, don't make it a song, because for too long the church has only sang songs. This morning, make it your prayer. This morning, make it your prayer with everything that is within you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Let's get some oil.
Hallelujah.
You provide the fire, and I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit, and I will open up inside. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God.
Yes, get full, get full, get full this very minute. Get full.
Fill me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Fill me.
Yes, Sarabahanda Barasi and Tiyahi and Barasi.
Fill me.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Receive it, receive it, receive it, receive it. For if you ask, you will receive, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit. And I will open up inside. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up. Till I overflow, I wanna run over, I wanna run over. Fill me up, till I overflow, I wanna run over, I wanna run over. You provide the fire, and I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit, and I will open up inside. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over, I wanna run over. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over, I wanna run over. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up, Lord, until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Lord Jesus, I wanna run over with all of my problems. I want it to run out of my spirit. And I want to run over with you, Lord. Fill me with your spirit, Lord. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. You provide the fire. I'll provide the sacrifice. You provide the spirit. And I will open up inside. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up, God. Fill me up. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up until I overflow. I wanna run over. 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 I wanna run. I wanna run over. God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom. You know just what to do. God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you. Give me wisdom. You know just what to do. I will love you, Lord, my strength. I will love you, Lord, my shield. And I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever, all my days, I will love you, God. God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom. You know just what to do. I will love you, Lord, my strength. I will love you, Lord, my shield. And I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever, all my days, I will love you, God. Hallelujah. God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Forever all my days. Hallelujah. God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. And God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom. You know just what to do. I will love you, Lord, my strength. I will love you, Lord, my shield. I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever all my days, I will love you, God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you. You're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom. You know just what to do. I will love you, Lord, my strength. I will love you, Lord, my shield. I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever all my days, I will love you, God. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns. Hallelujah, our God reigns forever all my days. Hallelujah. God, I look to you, I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you, you're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom, you know just what to do. I will love you, Lord, my strength. I will love you, Lord, my shield. I will love you, Lord, my rock. Forever all my days, I will love you, God. God, I look to you. I won't be overwhelmed. Give me vision to see things like you do. God, I look to you, you're where my help comes from. Give me wisdom.
And let's stand together. Let's stand together. We're standing. Okay. I'm in the spirit. Lift your hands this morning. We've moved from a place where we've been learning this morning about being true worshipers. We've been learning about what it is to come into that intimacy of the Lord. There's a deep anointing here. Then Pastor Louis took us in and spoke about how Jubilee breaks the chains. How Jubilee breaks the chains. Can I have a little bit of volume on this mic? Thanks. On SM58. Blue. 1, 2. And we learnt about that. We learnt that it was so important that as we come into our Jubilee, we must leave those things behind. We mustn't let them be dragged through. Otherwise, we're going to lose momentum of the Spirit. So now we're going to sing a song. Pastor Louis wants us to end with a punchy song. We're going to sing Come to the Water. And it was part of what his message was about. And so as we sing this song, come up and celebrate that the chains have been broken as you move into your Jubilee. Come up and celebrate in the river. Come and get in the river this morning. Come on.
There's a war going on just across the street. There's a rage that's burning to an angry beat. I can feel the thirst, but there's no relief. We need a river. There's a sound in the distance like a thunder cloud, waiting for the rain while the sun beats down. Can you feel it rising from the underground? We need a river.
Come on!
Oh, let justice roll like rivers. Let mercy flow with love, love. Come to the water, come to the water of life. It will never run dry. Come to the water and run to the water of life. It will never run dry.
peacemakers on our feet. Take us to the place blood and mercy meet.
Here is a river. Oh, let justice roll like rivers. Let mercy flow with love, love. And come to the water, come to the water of life. It will never run dry. Come to the water and run to the water of life. It will never run dry. Come, come to the water. Come to the water of life. It'll never run dry. Come to the water and run to the water of life. It'll never run dry.
Lord, forgive us for preaching a gospel that we don't always show, while millions all over this planet are dying of spiritual thirst. We're greedy and selfish in our ways. But God, I heard you say that if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, you will hear our prayers. Give us water that'll satisfy. So sing!
Come to the water, come to the water of life. It will never run dry. Come to the water and run to the water of life. It'll never run dry. Come to the water and come to the water of life. It'll never run dry.
Resurrection
of
power
a living God.
Of a living God.
Inside of me.
Inside of me.
I've been raised to life.
I've been raised to life.
The curse of death.
The curse of death.
Has been broken.
Has been broken.
So I speak life.
So I speak life.
Over my mind.
Over my mind.
Over my body.
Over my body.
Over my soul.
Over my soul.
Over my spirit.
Over my spirit.
And I declare.
And I declare.
Every chain.
Every chain.
Be broken.
Be broken.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Woo.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I think, is lunch ready? Please enjoy yourselves. If anybody lost some tickets, please just speak to Kerry over there at the table. There's some tickets we found in the stairs. Come and keep in the flow when you come back in. We're in another flow, and we're going to be blessed after lunch by Apostle Noctula, who's going to minister to us in a big way. So please go and have lunch. There is chicken curry and...
Chicken biryani.
Sorry, chicken curry, biryani, and... And there's some limited portions of chicken a la king. So, first come, first serve, but please enjoy. And we'll see you here in an hour at, what's the time now, Pastor Lou? Yes, 25 to 1. So we'll see you here at Hopos 1. God bless.